topic on sustainability, because we are in retail, and we retail in food, so of course there will be waste, it's a natural business. So we feel that in Tesco, being a retailer, we do have a big part to play. So as you know, Tesco Group has taken a really big initiative and really committed to support the United Nations Sustainability Development Goals. And in fact, our group CEO, Mr. Dave Lewis, is a chairperson of this particular group called Champions 12.3, a coalition of leaders from the government, corporates, universities, and civil rights societies. And the function of Champions 12.3 is to accelerate the progress of UN SDG Goal 12.3, which is to halve per capita waste at retail and consumption levels, and so to reduce the waste in the food chain and the production by 2030. Okay, so this is a big deal for Dave, and the UK, our parent company in the UK, has gone a long way on food waste, a couple of years already. So what I'm going to share with you today is what Malaysia is doing to support this particular goal. So as you can hear from the speakers this morning, we've got a lot of issues on food waste, right? So in Malaysia alone, we have, I think the report by SW Corp says, on a daily basis, around 15,000 tons of food is wasted. Food, out of which 3,000 is still edible. Okay, so we've got to do something about this. So I'll share with you our 3-year journey to give you a bit of an idea how we're going to tackle this. So in 2016, we created a program called the Food Surplus Donation, because we wanted to sort of lead the way by rescuing all of the edible but unsold food from our stores and channeling it out to those in need. So in 2017, we started to create more awareness with our colleagues, with our customers, and also with our children in our community. And in 2018, we're going to start to measure our waste. It's a lot of work there, because we also work with consultants from the UK to try and actually understand how much food waste is it that we're generating in our business, and what are the hot spots, so that we can actually set targets for ourselves to reduce it. So let me give you a bit of a snapshot around what we've done. So back in 2016, as I said to you, we sat down in the office and said, okay, let's try to rescue the food that we generate every day. Yeah, let's see how we can do that, and let's identify which are the partners that we can work with so that the food can be distributed. So we found two very reliable partners, which are food banks. It's Sekacara's Kitchen and Food Aid Foundation, who are also really, really passionate about food waste and also food and hunger. So we identified the products which we think, for trial, can withstand the logistics process and also the temperature without the use of cold chain so much. So we selected the bakery products as a start. It took us 6 months really to try and get that in place. And I think after that we had a very simple process to train our stores. And I'm very happy to tell you that all of our 56 stores in Malaysia are already donating food every day in our business. And I want to share with you a bit of a success story, a collaboration that we're doing, what we did with our parent, Sam Darby. I don't know whether everybody knows, but Sam Darby holds 30% share in Tesco Malaysia. So when we were trialing just now, right, in October 2016, Sam Darby, or Yayasan Sam Darby, also had a Young Innovators Challenge, a thing that they do every year to try to get school children to innovate and use science, yeah, in their daily lives. And the winning idea actually came from a group of 4 Sabahan students who created a food app called Roaming Food. So, you know, you can key in all of the food and surpluses that you have, it's sent to the food bank, and the food bank will be able to sort of gauge and you know, indicate how much they can collect and when they can collect it. So it's a nice little tech that they've put in together to allow us to seamlessly do this process when we donate from the stores. So I'm happy to tell you that up to now, we have managed to rescue 460 tons of food, which is equivalent to 1.8 million meals, right? So all of this has gone to more than 100 charities and people in the urban poor and also underserved communities in Malaysia. So we didn't, you know, after we had our food surplus program, we also wanted to campaign this a bit further, advocating it. And we started, of course, with our colleagues, having bits of competition in the office, encouraging them to sort of go out with our food bank partners to distribute the food so they can feel that they've done something. And I think the feedback's been very, very positive. We also tried to do our bits with the customers, and especially during festive seasons, we will call all the celebrity chefs to try and show with them to them what it is like to, you know, cook properly and sensibly. We call it the food waste cooking demo, so they can also do their bit at home. And with school children, I thought we should try to start people when they're young. And we've got another program in Tesco where we adopt 61 schools, one for each store, our DCs and our head office. And with that, we've got you know, workshops about food waste, so that they can go off and actually do their own thing in school. And as Tanshi pointed out earlier last year, or this year, we've partnered with Mardi to try to innovate the way we advocate by having this thing called Kebun Dapur, or the Edible Garden Kitchen, where there is lots of first-hand experience by students in the way they will plant the plants and composting later on when the plants are, you know, dead or being used. So I think a great load of things are being shared with our younger generation, they can also advocate for us in future. So after doing that, as I said to you earlier, we will measure and target and set within the business the target or the focal point of how we can reduce waste better. I think we're starting to talk to suppliers to really understand what they can do to innovate and reduce the quality, increase the quality of the food so they don't get to waste very fast. And I think we are also speaking to various other food producers to try and get them to come and join us in this particular initiative as well. That's a small bit about food waste, and I also wanted to share with you, as what Prof. Sumi is saying, things about we do for the environment. The first thing is about plastics. As you know, single-use plastic bag is a real big no-no. On average, Malaysian actually throws about 300 plastic bags every year, and most of this will end up in the sea and endangering the marine life. So, in conjunction with World Earth Day last year, in April, decided to sort of do a little bit of a campaign called the Unforgettable Bags. So what it means is, if you come and get these Unforgettable Bags from Tesco, you will be rewarded 20 cents. There's a barcode on each of the bags. So when you come and scan your bags out from the checkout, you'll get 20 cents as an incentive. So for those of you who live in Selangor, you know that if you ask for a bag, you have to pay 20 cents. But for us, if you bring your bag, you'll get 20 cents back. So hopefully, the campaign is trying to get people to not forget their plastic bags in the car. Okay? So the good news is, we've seen the statistics. It's been running for a couple of months now, since March, and about 70% of consumers who got these bags are bringing them back to reuse. Hopefully there's a huge impact by the end of the year. Next is about recycling packaging. So the Tesco Group is also very passionate about recycling our own packaging. Tesco own brand products, we are trying to have a target by 2025, all of our packaging has to be recycled. So we are talking as well with our big producers to try and see what kind of material they use for packaging and actually to reduce packaging altogether if we can. And of course the more important part is the closed loop recycling. It is our vision a bit far-fetched but for now, but I think it will sort of materialize sometime in the future. So we are hoping that what Tanshi is saying, to try and get everything that we use to be recycled, and I'm happy to tell you Tanshi that the Nilai one is actually going to be pretty replaced with a better sort of recycling center where you can actually recycle not just plastic or clothes or paper, but also computers and batteries. So we're working with iCycle, which will be able to sort of extract all of this and put it into good use. So watch that space. So we're trying out some of this in some of our stores, at least 6 stores for a start, and then the learning from there will allow us to create a better sort of recycling system. But we would love the government to make to take in more effort to try and support more sustainable waste management, especially because we don't have infrastructures to help us do that. So last but not least, I'm saying that I want all of you who are the future leaders of today to be the advocate to join us in this particular cause. I mean, I'm really thrilled to hear the passion in this room this morning from all of our speakers. And I know that you guys are here because you want to be here. So join us in this fight against waste. And as I said earlier, Tesco Malaysia is probably the only retailer that is distributing food or rescuing food on a daily basis. But I think this has been a development, and I'm happy to note that Kementerian Dalam Negeri dan Kepergudaan is also has recognized this effort. And last week, we asked to brief some of the retailers because it is in their wish that they'll make it like a big program, encouraging all other retailers to do the same. So we are heading to the right direction, and hopefully we'll see more, intention and more interest from the government to change behavior. Thanks for listening.